Welcome to Brilliant Corners. My name's Thomas Wendt, and on behalf of Lighthouse Arts, Inc., we welcome you to our online series. For more episodes like this, as well as other content, visit our website, lighthouseartsmusic.org. You can also follow us on social media, on Facebook and Instagram, at Lighthouse Arts, Inc. By 1942, Kenny Clarke was at the forefront of the development of American music. Performing with musicians like Thelonious Monk, Charlie Christian, and Dizzy Gillespie, his innovations were being felt throughout the music world. In 1942, he was drafted into the U.S. military during World War II. Around this time, Kenny had a brief marriage with singer Carmen McRae, and it was during his service in Europe that he met a very promising, talented young pianist from Albuquerque, New Mexico, by the name of John Lewis. The two vowed to continue collaborating musically once their service in the military ended. And in 1946, both of them were back in New York City, and Clarke introduced John Lewis to Dizzy Gillespie, who was putting together his first big band to play this new music that the critics were calling bebop. Now, in the early 1940s, Clarke had taken the innovations of the great drummer Papa Joe Jones, who took the timekeeping from the hi-hat cymbals over to the ride cymbal, or the top cymbal, as it was sometimes called. Clarke took this and then created an entire new language for drummers to use going forward. Drummers like Max Roach would take this language and expand upon it. In 1946, Kenny Clarke did join Dizzy Gillespie's brand new bebop big band. In addition, he also made records under his own name for small independent record labels like Savoy, Musicraft, and even a couple of European labels as well. On December 22nd of 1947, Kenny Clarke entered the recording studios of the RCA Victor record label with Dizzy Gillespie's bebop big band to make some incredibly important recordings. Dizzy was one of the early pioneers of fusing Afro-Cuban music with American jazz. And on December 22nd of 47, Dizzy, Clarke, and the big band recorded several pieces that were truly fusion music. The young composer and arranger George Russell wrote an innovative suite called Cubano B, Cubano Bop for the band. But the big hit of the day was a tune composed by Dizzy Gillespie and Cuban Kunga master drummer Chano Pozo. The name of the tune is Manteca. Let's check out Clarke with the band playing this tune. Now, in the next few years, Kenny Clarke would play and record with a variety of bands and band leaders. But at the top of the 1950s, he found himself once again at the forefront of American music innovation when he returned to play with the rhythm section of the Dizzy Gillespie Big Band in the form of a new group called the Modern Jazz Quartet. Along with Clarke on drums, his Pittsburgh brethren Ray Brown on bass, pianist John Lewis, and vibraphonist Milt Jackson, this was the original Modern Jazz Quartet. Here's a little bit of their unique arrangement of Jerome Kern's All the Things You Are from 1952. Check it out. Thank you. Kenny Clarke left the Modern Jazz Quartet shortly after Ray Brown's departure. But, as I'm sure you've guessed by now, this is not where Clarke's story ends. Please join us next time for part three of this series, where we'll see just where Kenny Clarke goes from here. Thanks so much for joining us today on Brilliant Corners. For more episodes like this, as well as other content, visit our website, lighthouseartsmusic.org, and follow us on social media on Facebook and Instagram at Lighthouse Arts Inc. We hope to see you again soon, but in the meantime, stay safe and stay close to the music.